fiddleheads like moist soil. They like to be close to the water. Fiddleheads really like to be flooded. So it's like they don't mind putting the feet in the water, but they don't want to be underwater all the time. Now the best fiddlehead areas we have is when the rivers rise and flood the area for about a week and then recedes. Great fiddleheads. If you don't get that condition and it gets warm and hot without the flooding in the water, they will grow overnight. So boom, up they go, and you end up with a fern and not a fiddlehead. Fiddleheads have no known toxins. What it is, picture this. Here's the riverbed, water running. Here's the bed itself where the fiddleheads are growing. And guess what? Up here is a hog farm. It's raining. The water's rising. And the effluent from the hog farm is running. It's going on the bed. It's going in the river. The river rises. What's going to happen to those fiddleheads? Or any produce that you have? It would become contaminated. So fiddleheads do not have toxins. Now, our plant, we disinfect everything. We have lab tests every day. Every production goes through the lab to see if there's any E. coli on it, and there's nothing. So most other little producers out there, they don't do that. They don't have the facilities, they don't have the means. So if you end up picking fiddleheads and there's a hog farm up above, you better make sure you want to boil those fiddleheads, because if you don't, you're going to get sick. There's two ways. You can either steam them, and if you do steam them, they have a little of a bitter taste like rapini. If on the other hand you boil them, and I do prefer mine boiled, 10-12 minutes, or you go 8 minutes and a little bit al dente. I prefer mine with butter or olive oil, salt and pepper, and cheese on top of it. And I can eat them 3 times a day, which I do in season. So you can freeze fiddleheads, blanch them for 3 minutes in boiling water, throw them into cold water to remove the heat, into a Ziploc, a little bit of water, take the air out, there you go. And it will be good for years and years and years. I'm telling you, when I say years, we've got fiddleheads sitting in our fridge, which we've been testing 5 years. They've been frozen, and they're perfect. But you make sure you put water in it to keep them from freezing burn.